فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My beloved brothers and sisters, it wasn't very long ago when we were getting ready and preparing for the entering of the month of Ramadan. And now what we see is Ramadan is coming to an end. So the question that presents itself, إِنَّ السُّؤَالَ الْمَطْرُوحَ الْآنَ بِإِلْحَاحِ, the question that presents itself seriously in front of each and every one of us is, هَلْ أَخَذْنَا بِأَسْبَابِ الْقَبُولِ بَعْدَ رَمَضَانِ. Have we, each and every one of us, have we taken the means for Allah to accept Ramadan from us? This is a question that everyone needs to ask himself. أيام معدودات. Little days, inshallah, soon Ramadan will be gone. The question that you need to ask yourself is, هل أخذنا بأسباب القبول بعد رمضان? When Ramadan goes, have we come with the means for Allah to accept Ramadan from us? And we also need to ask ourselves, have we taken the unwavering conviction على مواصلة الأعمال الصالحة to carry on the righteous deeds after Ramadan is gone? That we're not going to stop what we started. The fasting that we came with, inshallah, after Ramadan, we're going to carry on. The qiyam that we came in Ramadan, when Ramadan goes, we're going to still carry on. Have we made that decision in our minds? Have we asked ourselves that question? هل تأسينا بالسلف الصالح? Have we treaded on the path of the pious predecessors? In which matter? In the fact that they used to be very scared and concerned, and they used to be worried if Ramadan has gone, has it been accepted from us? This was a consistent fear in their hearts. Al-Imam Al-Hafiz Ibn Rajab Al-Hanbali, in his great book, Lata'if Al-Ma'arif, in which he talks about what the Prophet used to do in the whole year. In the whole year, every month, what was it that the Prophet used to focus on? And in the month of Ramadan, Ibn Rajab mentions the following statements that I'm going to bring. He says, عن معل بن فضل, that the Salaf, such as معل بن فضل, he used to, أنهم كانوا يدعون الله ستة أشهر, 6 months after Ramadan has gone and he has departed, they used to supplicate and beg Allah that he accepts it from them. So when Ramadan was in, they were working hard. كانوا يجتهدون في إتمام العمل وإكمالي وإتقاني. They would strive hard. They would put every effort in making sure that they fasted correctly, and they would put every effort in making sure that they stood up at light very well. But when it went, they used to be concerned if it would be accepted from them. So they had two things: itqanu al-amal wa ikmali, making sure that they did the action very well. They solidified their deeds. And once they have left Ramadan, they used to then be worried and concerned, was it accepted from them? سألت عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, our mother, عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, الصديقة, بنت الصديق, the truthful one, whose father was truthful. رضي الله تعالى عنها, she asked her husband, the messenger, صلى الله عليه وسلم, she asked him about the meaning of the verse, والذين يؤتون ما آتوا وقلوبهم وجلة those who come with what they come with and their hearts are in a state of fear. She said, O Messenger of Allah, أهم الذين يزنون ويسرقون ويشربون الخمر. Are they the ones who commit zina, who steal and they drink alcohol? قال لا. The Messenger responded and said to Aisha, No. يبنة الصديق, the daughter of Abu Bakr. That's not what it is. And that's not what the verse means. ولكن لهم الذين يصلون ويصومون ويتصدقون ويخافون أن لا يتقبل منهم. Rather, they are the people who pray, they fast, they give in charity. ويخافون أن لا يتقبل منهم. And they are scared that it may not be accepted from them. No one knows from amongst us if the action of fasting and the sadaqah that we came with and the qiyam that we came with, whether Allah is going to accept it. يقول علي بن أبي طالب خليفة الراشد, علي بن أبي طالب, the cousin of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, كونوا لقبول العمل أشد اهتماما منكم بالعمل. ألم تسمعوا إلى قول الله عز وجل, إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. علي بن أبي طالب, he said, be very concerned of the acceptance of the action more than coming with the action itself. Be more concerned if the action is going to be accepted from you than the coming with the action itself. Have you not heard of the statement of Allah? إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah only accepts from those who are pious. So if Allah accepts your fasting, if Allah accepts your standing in Ramadan, it's an indication that you're a pious person, because Allah accepts from those who are pious. وَقَالَ فَضَالَةَ بْنُ عُبَيْدٍ, فَضَالَةَ بْنُ عُبَيْدٍ, he said, لو أني أعلم أن الله تقبل مني مثقال حبة خردل. لو أني أعلم, if I was to only know, أن الله تقبل مني, that Allah has accepted from me a mustard seed of righteous deeds. أحب إلي من الدنيا وما فيها. That is more beloved to me than this dunya and everything that is in it. If I was sure today that there is an action as small as a mustard seed that Allah has accepted from me, that would be more beloved to me than من الدنيا وما فيها, this world that you see, the glitters and the glamours and every simple thing that is in it. لأن الله يقول, because Allah says, إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين, because Allah only accepts from those who are pious. Fadalat ibn Ubayd is trying to say that I by default have become a righteous person if Allah accepts from me subhanahu wa ta'ala. Amr ibn Dinar rahimahullah, he said, الخوف على العمل ألا يتقبل أشد من العمل. Fear of the action not being accepted is greater than coming with the action itself. أيها المسلمون, O Muslims, الذين ذاقوا طعم الإيمان, those of you who have tasted the sweetness of Iman, those of you who have stood up at night and fasted at day, استجبتم لربكم, you obeyed your Lord in this noble month of Ramadan. استجيبوا له في سائر الأيام, obey him in the next coming months, obey him in the next coming days. Do not worship Allah only in Ramadan. When the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died and his body was there sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr entered onto the people. Umar made the people stand in a corner. And Umar said, no one can say that the Messenger died. Abu Bakr came to the people and he said the following statement. من كان يعبد محمدا, anyone who was worshiping Muhammad, فإن محمدا قد مات. ومن كان يعبد الله فإن الله حي لا يموت. Anyone who was worshiping Muhammad, Muhammad is dead. And anyone who was worshiping Allah, Allah is حي, he will never die. The same is what we say to the people. who was worshipping Allah only Ramadan, then Ramadan is gone now. But anyone who's worshipping Allah, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيُّ لَا يَمُوتُ. Allah does not die. He is the Lord of every other month after Ramadan. We have to be conscious of this. استجيبوا لربكم. Respond to your Lord and obey Him. من قبل أن يأتي يوم لا مرد له من الله. Before it comes to you a day in which there is no repelling from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أيها الإخوة الفضلاء. أيها المسلمون. All believers. لقد جاءت النصوص الشرعية. Many textual evidences have come in commanding each and every one of us بالعبادة الله, in worshipping Allah, والاستقامة على شرعه, and to be steadfast upon His legislation في كل زمان ومكان, every time and every place, ومطلقة في كل وقت وآن, and every time and every place. Worshipping Allah and being steadfast on His legislation is not restricted to a month, and it is not restricted to a day, and it is not restricted to a time. يقول الحسن البصري رحمه الله, he said, لا يكون لعمل المؤمن أجل دون الموت. وقرأ قوله سبحانه, واعبد ربك حتى يأتيك اليقين. حسن البصري said that the believer, his actions do not have a restricted time. The believer's actions are not restricted to a duration and a time, except when death comes to him. And then he recited the verse, وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ, worship your Lord, حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ, until death comes to you. You worship Allah until you taste the bitterness of death. وَلَمَّا سُئِلَ الْبِشْرُ الْحَافِي, when Bishr al-Hafi was asked and he was told about عَلَىٰ أُنَاسٍ يَتَعَبَّدُونَ اللَّهَ فِي رَمَضَانِ وَيَجْتَهِدُونَ فِيهَا, when he was informed about a people that they are working hard in the month of Ramadan and they are striving and they are putting every effort in Ramadan. فَإِذَا انْسَلَخَ رَمَضَان, but when Ramadan goes, تَرَكُوا, they leave off everything. قال, he responded by saying, بئس القوم لا يعرفون الله إلا في رمضان. Evil are these people, they do not know Allah except in the month of Ramadan. يقول الكعب القرظي, كعب القرظي رحمه الله, he said, من صام رمضان, anyone who fasts the month of Ramadan, وهو يحدث نفسه, and whilst he's fasting in Ramadan, he tells himself, and now إذا خرج رمضان, as soon as Ramadan goes, عسى ربه, I'm going to disobey Allah. Ramadan is the only thing that's stopping me. Inshallah, I will restrain myself, I will hold myself together for just these 30 or 20 odd nights, and when Ramadan goes, I will disobey Allah. He said, فَصِيَامُهُ عَلَيْهِ مَرْدُودٌ, his fasting will be rejected in his face. وَبَابُ التَّوْفِيقِ فِي وَجْهِ مَسْتُودٌ, and the door of Allah giving him the ability in the future will be blocked from him. أَيُّهَا الْمُسْلِمُونَ, do not be like that which Allah said about the woman. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّتِي نَقَضَتْ غَزْلَهَا مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ أَنْكَاثًا. Do not be like the woman who sat down and she made a knot in a rope, and then in the evening she came and she untied her knot. All she did was she undone what she did. You worked hard in this noble month of Ramadan. Don't untie it in the months to come. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل, وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد آخر الأنبياء في الدنيا عصرا, وأجلهم يوم القيامة شأنا وذكرا, صلى الله وملائكته والصالحون من خلقه كما وحد الله وعرف به ودعا إليه. اعلموا رحمكم الله Know, my beloved brothers and sisters, that after Ramadan leaves, Eid is what to take place straight after Ramadan. Many people are going to be happy, and they have every right to. Allah has made it for a time every believer should be happy. But I want to remind you, who is the one who's truly happy? أن السعيد في العيد. Ibn al-Qayyim said that the one who is happy in Eid ليس من لبس الجديد وتنعم بالغيد وإنما السعيد في العيد من خاف يوم الوعيد وسلم من العذاب الشديد. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said that the happy one in the month of Ramadan is not the one who has worn new clothes or the one who blesses himself with nice cotton clothing. But the happy one in the Eid day is what? من خاف يوم الوعيد. The one who fears Allah even on the day of Eid to exceed his boundaries and to go against Allah's commands. وسلم, and he is safe من العذاب الشديد. وهيب بن الوردي رحمه الله, he came by a group of people on the day of Eid laughing and joking and enjoying themselves. مر وهيب بن الوردي رحمه الله على أناس يلهون ويلعبون أيام العيد. They were enjoying themselves. They were having fun on the day of Eid. فقال لهم, he said to them, عجبا لكم, fascination be with you all. إن كان الله تقبل صيامكم. If Allah accepted your fasting for you, and that it may be the case, فما هذا عمل الشاكرين, then this what you guys are doing is not the action of those who are showing gratitude. وإن كان الله, but if Allah لم يتقبله منكم, but if Allah didn't accept the fasting from you, فما هذا عمل الخائفين, then this joying and laughing around is not the action of those who are scared. اعلموا رحمكم الله. Know, my beloved brothers and sisters, that our messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he urged us, he recommended for us, بصيام ستة أيام من شوال, that we fast 6 days of شوال, which is the month to come after Ramadan. فقد روى الإمام مسلم في صحيح, and Imam Muslim narrated in his صحيح, من حديث أبي رضي الله, من حديث أبي أيوب الأنصاري رضي الله تعالى عنه, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, من صام رمضان وأتبعه ستا من شوال كان كصيام الدهر. That the messenger said, anyone who has fasted Ramadan and then he follows it up with 6 days of Shawwal, it is equal to fasting the whole year. So the person fasts the month of Ramadan and then he follows it up with 6 days after it in Shawwal. Now the question arises, does the person have to fast straight away after Eid consecutively? The answer is no. As long as he fasts 6 days within the month of Shawwal. The messenger made the matter easy for the person. أيها المسلمون, my beloved brothers and sisters, حاسبوا أنفسكم, account yourselves, put yourselves to accountability, بعد صيام شهركم, after this month of Ramadan finishes. Sit down, Ramadan has gone, account yourselves. إذا كان أرباب الأموال وأصحاب التجارات, because the people who own businesses after the annual month or after the year, they sit down and they calculate their money, the income, the net, the gross, they look at it all. The believer needs to do the same with his righteous deeds and look at it. قال الله تعالى, Allah said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول ولا تبطلوا أعمالكم. Those of you who believe, obey Allah and obey the messenger and do not nullify your righteous deeds. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اغفر لنا هزلنا وجدنا وخطأنا وعمدنا وكل ذلك عندنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا تسلط علينا في ذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. رب آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وأقم الصلاة.